My name is Wayne Durbin, and I am the director of Major Gifts, as well as some other work that I do with the old Coffee YMCA. And I really want to welcome you all here this evening for this wonderful event to really support the YMCA of Haiti. You're going to be experiencing tonight some really exquisite, authentic Haitian food presented and developed by our top chef, Jocelyn Carline, who is the head chef here at Stonehill College and has generously donated his time, some of his staff time, to put this food together. And you can already smell the aroma of this wonderful food. And you'll be hearing a little bit more from Jocelyn about this food a little later in the program. You'll also be hearing a lot about the work the YMCA of Haiti is performing in Haiti, really transforming the Haiti YMCA into a really viable community organization. Already they have 10 community centers built in Haiti, and our program tonight is trying to help them complete the last part of the building expansion program in Jacques Bell. Again, we'll be hearing some more about that. So as you enjoy your food, we'll be talking about that. And really, when I think about the tremendous odds that the folks in Haiti have to deal with day in and day out, I have to be reminded by a quote from Hebrews in the Bible, which I think sum up the Haitian people's attitude. It goes like this. Faith is being sure of what you hope for. It's certain of what you do not see. And that's really what the Haitian people, in the course of years and years and years, never lost that hope. They kept that faith that they can have a strong country and a strong community. And that's what the YMCA is instilling in the folks of Haiti, is that hope and faith. At this point, I'd like to introduce a noted author from Haiti to give a quick reading from one of her books. I'd like to introduce Stephanie Pierre Lewis, and she'll be coming up here in a second. And she's written a book that she has available for sale in the back of Haiti in 26 Heartbeats. So, Stephanie, all yours.
How dedicated we are whenever we want to accomplish something. Nan peyi kote m soti a, gen yon resilyans ki semble l donen an ba tèt. Li pi fò pase tout fòs les om met ansan. Li pi solide pase rasinman. Mwen, m deside rele l rasin louvel ti. Louvel ti, paske papa nou te gen men fòs la. Li te gen menm kouraj la. Li te gen menm determinasyon pou goumen. Louvel ti paske sitadel la se an temwen fidel. De kote nou soti. De ki eskouye. Louvel ti paske lèm deside fon bagay pa gen liye ki ka kampe. Louvel ti paske nou gen tèt. Nou gen bra. Nou gen fyèl. Pour le secret de l'histoire cousu dans le repli de la chute de Catherine. Pour une île trappée entre deux Amériques vainqueurs. Pour le Jucan et le Jurisospoir, desquels mon cœur refuse de divorcer. Pour le folklore, le compas direct et le Yovalou, que mes têtes ne cessent de charrier. Pour les armes volées du drapeau qui ont tué mes frères. pour le bateau, l'avion, la mission et le dégoût qui nous ont transportés en terre étrangère. Pour l'acte d'indépendance d'un peuple illettré, racine nouvelle vie, racine 18 mai, racine 20e, racine mouvement, racine courage. Racine nouvelle vie, parce que l'histoire nous en a connu avec un sang bête, un sang sauvage, un sang morse, un sang gourmet, un sang victoire. Yon sans liberté, yon sans gagner. Racine nous vertu, parce que l'histoire noire marche de tous côtés dans le monde. Racine nous vertu, parce que l'air unifié, pas gagné à mettre nous en terre. Racine nous vertu, parce que Haïti belle, Haïti fort, Haïti belle.
Thank you. Thank you, Stephanie. And don't forget to, if you're interested in her book, they're for sale on the back there. And the Haiti Project will get part of those proceeds from those book sales for our fundraising here tonight. Speaking of fundraising, we do have a raffle going on tonight, and we have some great prizes. We have a one-year membership to any Old Colony-wide branch, which is valued at a little over $900. A 1 week at any of our day camps, at Old Colony YMCA, it's about a $300 value. We have a delicious gift basket from Hilliard's. There's a lighter rocking chair that will be wrapped off today, and that's valued about $400, thanks to the generosity of Roy and Barbara Wolf. And finally, we have a once-in-a-lifetime experience that Chef Jocelyn will provide for a dinner party at 8 at your home. And you can help him select the menu. It doesn't have to be Haitian food. It can be any kind of food you like. You work with him at a mutually agreed upon date and location. And Jocelyn will come to your house with the food and prepare it and explain the process behind the food. So it'll be good, fun evening night. And we really have a value of that and priceless. So don't forget to buy your raffle tickets, because it's a fundraiser for our friends in Haiti. So please, be generous. Along with that, if you're even interested more in the project in Haiti, on the tables is a brochure. It's called Building Beyond Borders. And that'll give you a little bit more of an explanation of what we're trying to do to help our friends in Haiti construct this last YMCA, which I've met. And you can read through that, and there's an opportunity to fill out a pledge card, and you can mail that into the Old Colony Y, or you can give it to myself or some people at the front registration desk if you're interested in that, and we're more than happy to thank you for your extra gifts tonight. So with that, I'm excited to share with you our MC for the evening. He's a business owner, he's a community leader, he's a radio TV announcer in the Boston area, and he's currently running for the 5th District of the City Council in Boston, but I think more importantly, that he's been married for 38 years. So with that really brief introduction, I'd like to introduce to you Jean-Claude Sasson.
If we're going to have some fun here this evening, it's going to be difficult to separate you from the food. However, good evening, everyone. Okay. If I could shift your attention for just one moment. Let me see what everyone is here with me. Good evening, everyone. A pleasure for me to be here. This is a night that I have been dreaming of, and tonight it's finally come to a reality. My name is Jean-Claude Sasson. I am normally a voice that is very well recognized in Boston because of the fact that we do both radio and televisions. But however, tonight I'm here for a great cause. Let me take the opportunity to thank, first of all, the Stonehill College, who has opened up the door so we can have this whole movement in here this evening. And second of all, the YMCA, which I'm gonna tell you a little bit about. I had a snapshot. I'm gonna see what if my memory is still on set, because it's a great, great organization. And lastly, the man who brought me in here tonight. He's the man that you are tasting his food. He's the man that you are, who's touching your heart this evening, whether if it's hot or cold, whatever the type of food it is. Think of the chef in the house with us. And lastly, I want to thank each and every one of you who have stepped out tonight. It's a great evening. If it's a great evening, let me help all of you in the house here. Give yourself a round of applause. You stepping out on a great evening. You're going to be outside enjoying the nice weather. You are here, we're going to have a good time, and we're going to have some fun, okay? Thank you to each and every one of you. There was a person who was very close to me that actually worked in here, because we've been married for so long, and I promised just now I was going to bring my wife in tonight, but unfortunately I could not. Too many guests, normally at the house, so I had to leave her behind. But unfortunately, I'm going to be taking over every single minute right now, because my wife had a stroke on March 11th. And I witnessed this from first sight. She is improving, she's getting much better. And thanks to people like you who are very concerned. Thanks to those who have prayed for us as a family. And thanks to those who have supported us. One of these days, another event, I'll make sure that she comes in here and she's able to walk and be able to participate with each and every one of you. If you didn't notice, back in 1844 was the year that the YMCA was established. So for some of you who are here who never heard of anything like this, it was 1844. And it was done for the right cause. And you all in here understand the meaning of the word Y, Young, M, Man, C, Christian. And A is associations. Now, because young men in England were suffering a lot in terms of social, in terms of economics and so on and so forth, so this organization was founded in 1844. Now, following that, guess what? Within the same year, they moved to where? To Montreal, Canada. And right after, it was the United States. So you are enjoying the works of people who have really cared about other people and who have put this whole organization together. So with that said, I will not be talking too much. Even if you are enjoying the food, or you are enjoying the art, or you are enjoying everyone, just keep in mind, whoever's going to come up here to perform, you need to give them a little bit of attention. Okay? Because your speaking can intimidate any speakers that comes up here if they don't have what it takes to really perform in front of an audience. So please, bear in mind, okay folks? With that said, the man with the biggest hat in the house. I kind of met this man just by accident. Here I am coming down Blue Avenue in Mattapan, and a man is coming down the street with a uniform on. And I said, who is that? They introduced me to him as one of the Haitian American chefs. And a friend says, this is Jocelyn Owen. Guess what? This is just like a brother to me. After a few weeks, we have connected so well. I've been on the radio with him, I've been on the televisions with him, and Jocelyn really took this to heart. And so did I, so we can make this event what it is tonight. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please help me welcome to the house, Jocelyn Owen in the house.
Evening, everyone. Thank you, Jean-Claude. Well, thank you all for coming here tonight. It's a privilege to be up here to talk about Haiti, talk about Stonehill College, YMCA, all three of them together. I'm not going to take a lot of time. I'm going to talk about the food. When Dwayne approached me with the idea of building the YMCA in Jacmel, where my family is from, my mom was born in Jacmel, and I said, yeah, I'll get involved. And I said, I'm going to do a little taste of Haiti. I'm going to buy tout le monde goûter un petit morceau Haiti. Un petit morceau Haiti in the food, in the music, in the art. And I got lucky. Mr. Charles Lucien joined us in the project. Jean-Claude Sano joined in. All the YMCA members, all the team, they joined in and they said, let's do this. And here is the food. The food we have, our national soup that we eat every January 1st. It's right there. We have all our appetizers that we make on the streets. This is street food that we are enjoying over there. And over there, this is the food that you would eat on a Sunday evening. That's Haiti national food that is at that station. But the desserts are things that I created myself with our flavors. You'll be enjoying some mango mousse, passion fruit mousse. You'll be enjoying some pepper tap. This is something that is typically Haitian that we make. And you'll be enjoying some rum-infused pineapple upside-down cake. All that will be coming a little later. At the drink station, it's also Haitian influence. We have passion fruit punch, mango punch, orange pineapple. This is all about the food. So I am happy to have all these people here enjoying my food. This is the one thing that I'm passionate about. Here at Stonehill College, I have 2,700 of them to feed every day, and I enjoy doing it. So today, this is nothing. A few hundred is nothing. I'm happy to have you here, and I cannot wait for you to tell me how you've enjoyed this food. Mr. Nakul, here is another partner that have joined me in this project and is running for City Council in Brockton. Sir? In the meantime, how is the food? Did I succeed?
Excellent.
Stefan, how is the food? Have you tried anything yet? Well, speaking about the food, what I didn't explain, all these stations are stand-alone stations. You can start at any of the stations. You don't need to stand in line. You can cut the lines. You can go start at this station, or you start at that one. It doesn't matter. Okay?
So how you doing, Christian? You doing well?
I'm doing very well.
How you guys doing? How you guys doing? Come on, make some noise. How you guys doing? Are you guys enjoying the food? Are you guys enjoying a taste of Haiti? Come on now, it's a taste of Haiti. Come on, we are here to have a taste of Haiti. But before I say anything, I would like you folks to put your hands together for this man right here, Jocelyn, who put this together with the YMCA. Come on guys, give this man a round of applause, because we need those people, not just for one day, but for as long as we can possibly do it. But before that, we gotta thank Stonehill College, obviously, for hosting us, and of course, the Brockton Cable Access, Mike Lending, who is my best friend, and also the chairman of the Brockton Board of Library, and of course, me and my friend, Jocelyn Ickey. So the food looks great. We are having fun. Tell me what do you think about what's going on.
Well,
tell me.
I'm enjoying this. I'm enjoying it so much.
You are enjoying it?
Let's give everything back to Jean-Claude Sano. Thank you very much, everyone, and I'll be talking to you throughout the evening.
Yeah, let's do it. So Jean-Claude Sano is going to take over, and I thank Jean-Claude Sano for impressing not just me, but all of us, because this is a taste of Haiti. And for those of you who don't know me, like he said, I'm Gene Bradley, the Rand Court. I'm running for City Council at large in Brockton, and it's an honor for me not just to be here, but of course to share this stage with one of the best Haitian men that we have in Massachusetts, Jean-Claude Sano. Jean-Claude Sano, the floor is yours. Let's do it, brother.
Thank you. We have some dignitaries in the house, so we're going to shift gear a little bit. Now, I will test you on anything. Now, if you were to meet anyone tonight who happens to be Haitian sitting next to you, what would you say to them? Bonsoir. For the English speaking, let's go. The first thing you would say to them is bonsoir. Okay? So, it's one way of breaking the ice, it's one way of introducing yourself, and it's one way of really feeling what's going on. President and CEO of the Old Colony YMCA. Very simple guy. I was sitting right next to him, I didn't even know who he was. He will be doing the introductions. Please, ladies and gentlemen, Give it up for the YMCA President and CEO.
Thank you very much. It's a real, I'll be back on the agenda a little bit later tonight to talk about our work in the with the YMCA in Haiti. However, for the moment, it really is my pleasure to introduce the mayor of Brockton, Bill Carpenter. He has been a long, steadfast supporter of the entire community, but particularly from my experience with the Haitian Community Partners, a real advocate for the Haitian community in Brockton and the surrounding area. And he's kind enough to spend some time in his busy schedule to join us this evening with a few words of welcome. Mayor Carpenter?
Well, good evening, everyone. It's great to be here with you at A Taste of Haiti. I'll be brief because I know everyone came for the food, not to listen to a program. But I just want to say what a great project this is for the Old Colony Y to be working with the YMCA of Haiti. It's an outstanding goal, and it reminds us and it reminds me how closely connected our Haitian American community in Brockton is with Haiti, and that I think that folks who are not part of the Haitian community in the city need to have a better understanding as to how closely connected our Haitian American community is with what's going on in Haiti, and that when something happens in Haiti, it impacts families in Brockton. And so many families in Haiti right now still rely upon assistance that's sent from their friends and family here in the United States. So I think this is just a great example of how we can use, with the Old Colony Y leading the way and their partnership with the Y in Haiti, to really bring assistance and help young people create opportunities and open up their futures in Haiti. So I am proud to be here, to be part of the event tonight. Jean-Claude, great to see you. And my thanks, Vinny, to everything that the Old Colony Y is doing to make this project a reality. To your board, who I know is supporting you in this endeavor. And the city of Brockton certainly shares the concerns for the people of Haiti that our Haitian American community does. And we are ready to be a full partner in any way that we can. So please enjoy the food, the great evening here at Stonehill. Thank you.
Now, does he look like a carpenter? Does he really look like a carpenter? Because it says it takes a carpenter to build a city, okay? The mayor of Brockton. Now, at some point, you're going to have Vinny Maturano, who's going to be coming back, to really tell you in much more details. But what is the word that you want to say to me that I have just taught most of you that speaks English? Bonsoir. Okay? So you make it plain and simple. Bonsoir Jean-Claude. Bonsoir Luc. Bonsoir. And so on and so forth. Okay? Then I'll tell you what to say before you leave here so that you make sure that you maintain that relationship. Okay? That'll be the second word. The lady in red is here already, right? And her name is Linda Thompson. She's going to describe to you the Haiti's features and art. Please, let's give it up for Linda Thompson in the house.
Bonsoir. Merci. I hope you're enjoying the evening so far. It's absolutely fabulous to see so many of you here. And I've only got as far as the soup. And I may be just keeping with the soup for the rest of the night because it's so good. I hope you've had a time to look at all the wonderful artwork that we have around. There's some gorgeous prints on the back wall there, done by photographer John Richter, Stephen Arneson, and Demutis Lafontaine. I apologize if I'm butchering his name, he's here. If anybody is interested in having copies of these prints, of these pictures, please see me at some time in the evening and I'll take your contact information and the photographer, I'll pass it on to the photographer because I know a couple of people have asked me already. Additionally, Jim King, who's a teacher at Thayer Academy here in Braintree, he has brought some of his own photographs, and these are to my right. And there's some wonderful photographs there, and we have one in the raffle. But I would like to introduce you to another Haitian gentleman. He's a master storyteller, a poet, and a visual artist, and he's also the founder of the Haitian Artists Assembly of Massachusetts. Please welcome Charlot Lucier.
Merci beaucoup. Let's try something. Sac passé. Sac passé. Thank you so very much. My name is Alain Charlot Lucien. I'm with the Haitian Artists Assembly of Massachusetts. This is to let you know that we have some Haitian arts on this side here that we are promoting as a silent auction. We have notable the price of these artworks that you may buy, and then you from the proceed will go back to the YMCA of Jacques Bell. Why? It's because we had a chance to be connected to the Jacques Bell community back in 2010 after we traveled after the Haiti earthquake. And we got a chance to speak with some of the artists and found out that Jacques Bell, which used to be a cultural and artistic landmark in Haiti, the artists had lost their motivation because either they've lost their houses, either they've lost their supplies. So as a result, there was no motivation to pay, and since the city was also impacted by the earthquake, there was no more tourists coming to buy their artwork. When we came back here, we connected with a few other entities, started to raise funds for the artists, and since 2010, we've been supporting the Réseau des Artistes de Jacques Mel, the network of Haitian artists in Jacques Mel. So we do happen to have some of the artworks here on the side, which you can take a look at and decide if you want to bid on them. Remember, when we say a taste of Haiti, it's not just about the culinary taste of Haiti, it is also about the visual taste of Haiti. It's also about the historic connection between Haiti and the U.S. Without getting any kind of a history lesson here, let's simply point out that the great Frederick Douglass, who spent time in Bridgewater, who spent time in Brooklyn and in Boston, has also been an ambassador to Haiti between 1891, 1889, and 1891. Just to say again that the connections are there, the connections are deep. So what I would like to invite you to do, in between breaks, you may stop by any of those paintings on my right. Some of them are oil painting in color that depict the situations in the landscape of Haiti. Some of them are black and white silhouettes in the drawings that are also original art deco that you can acquire for your offices or your home. Now, in the event you want to be, I invite you to please see a volunteer aid right here. If you want to stand up so people see who you are, where you are. So please see Evangeline if you want more information about those paintings, or see me, we'll be on this side. Thanks again for supporting this great cause. Thanks again for enjoying a taste of Haiti. With that, I will pass it back to Jean-Claude Sardon. And again, sac passé. Sac passé. Here we go.
You do have certainly a break time right now. You can go ahead and try the food. Remember, you don't have to start at one setting. You can go to the different ones. And just be on try each and every one of them. Enjoy the food. You can also purchase raffle tickets because there's a prize this evening that I think most of you would like to get. The one that is being offered by the chef, Justin William. He will come to your house and cook dinner for eight. It doesn't have to be the one that you're eating right now. It can be any type of food. If you want Italian, you want Asian, you want American, whatever you want, he will do it. So buy yourself a raffle ticket. All right? Give you a chance to really go and visit the exhibitions as well. And also, everything else that Charlotte had mentioned, it's the time for you to go check it out. And we will come back in just a few minutes with the next speaker for this evening. Thank you.
Takes hours, while the Accra, you need to create it. So I ended up
getting a special tool from Japan to do the grading so I do not get cut. So I have something made of plastic as opposed to metal. So this entire meal was a labor of love. The past 3 days I've been coming in at 4 o'clock in the morning just to get things ready. But then again, why not? Look at this, why not? I will do it again tomorrow if I have to. Enjoy the evening.
Behind every chef, there's a bigger chef. And the bigger chef is taking pictures right now. Let's give it out to Justin's wife, who's on the floor right now. Okay. The Old Colony YMCA is celebrating its 129th year of service to the community this year. Operating out of 5 branches in Brockton, Central, Youth, Child Care, Social Services, and Family Services. That's a lot of services. And 6 branches in the communities of East Bridgewater, Easton, Middleborough, Stoughton, Taunton, and Plymouth. The Y offers traditional health, wellness, sports, and child care programs, and comprehensive social service programs that respond to youth and families whose needs are more complicated and extensive. The President and Chief Executive Officer of Old Colony, Mr. Vincent J. Maturano, has 43 years of nonprofit management experience. He attended Springfield College, where he graduated magna cum laude with a Bachelor of Science degree. He earned his master's degree in social work from the University of Connecticut School of Social Work and was certified as an ACSW in 1978 from the Academy of Certified Social Workers. Mr. Maturano has been employed with the YMCA movement for his entire professional career, beginning as a youth director, outdoor center director for the Northern Middlesex YMCA in Middletown, Connecticut, since 1973. That's a lot of labor. That's a lot of work. It's a long career that I'm not gonna finish it up. But if you're a fan of... Anybody watch the game last night? Were some of you disappointed? Cavalier against... None of you watched the game last night? Man, that was the game. So if you didn't watch the game, you're going to make a double effort to help me introduce on the scene right now, coming up to the stage, Mr. Maturano in the house.
Thank you, Gene, and thank you all once again. So, for those of you that know me, I do have the gift of gab, and I'm not going to do that tonight. And the other thing is that I'm usually before your meal, so now at least you've been fed and hopefully you'll bear me a few minutes. On a very serious note, though, I did want to kind of present to you an overview of how we got here today and how important this project is as a priority for our YMCA and our community. So, the journey for us began about 3 years ago, and quite frankly, began as a result of our board of directors' initiative on greater emphasis on diversity and inclusion, and particularly a concept to be recognized by the YMCA of the USA as a global center of excellence. And as part of that outreach, we made a commitment to engage with a YMCA in another country. I will tell you that years ago, we were very instrumental in building the YMCA in Sri Lanka. So now we have another opportunity to do a similar effort, but in the community of Haiti. So at the time, we also were approached by Arlene Amade and the Haitian Community Partners to create a more closer working relationship with the local Haitian community organizations. So, as part of that effort, and I have to say that in concert with Dr. David Mudd, who is on our board, and has already made several medical mission trips to the community of Haiti,
we began talking about the subject of what do we do and how do we do it. So what we learned, and that essentially, quite frankly, I was astounded at how many Haitians or folks of Haitian origin live in Brockton or the greater Brockton area. And so that began an engagement, and before you know it, about a year ago, some of you will remember that we hosted the General Secretary, Benil Apollon, right here in Brockton as an emissary from the community of Haiti, and to begin our work together. So here's what the history is. The YMCA in Haiti was founded about 60 years ago by the YMCA in Montreal. And for many years, they had kind of ups and downs in their history. And then, unfortunately, came the earthquake of 2010. And at that time, it provided opportunities for the YMCA to be reborn again. And what we learned is one of the ways that it was reborn essentially was by building community centers through a very creative and innovative way to essentially provide local centers in different communities to provide services to kids and families in that country, if you will. By the way it works is, and I said very unique, but essentially we learned that as a result of all the containers that were being shipped with supplies and equipment to that community, the YMCA in Ridgewood, New Jersey, came up with this kind of novel idea to essentially create a community center by reconstructing these containers, if you will. And we're going to show you a couple of slides in a little while. And today, basically, you will see that there are about 4,000 square foot program center. The YMCA in Haiti currently, I believe, has 9 or 10 of these centers. And it has been our collective commitment to essentially raise enough money to build one of these centers in the community of Jacmel. Now, some may say, why Jacmel? And it's really, I think from what I understand, that there are a fair number of folks from Jacmel that did emigrate here to the United States. Further, the way this works is that typically it requires that land be found to construct the site on. And I'm very pleased to share and introduce to you a husband and wife couple, and I hope I don't mess the name up, but I'm going to try, but Stephen Francis and Vera Cloquet of our community, who are right over there, have graciously been working with the General Secretary in Haiti to identify the specific land, and I think that in a few minutes, some of the slides I'm going to show you will actually show where that site is. So, in terms of, so if we take the mystery out of it and really, you know, have a good understanding of what it's going to take, you know, it is not a project that is not attainable. Quite honestly, the project cost to construct the Y, $35,000, and annually it costs $15,000 to physically operate the center. So the commitment that we have made is to raise that money in the coming 12 months, and at the same time also each year continue to raise the operating support at $15,000 per year. So certainly within the greater Brockton community, we have the means and the capacity to do that. Now, what I'd like to, by the way, I don't want to take sole credit there. I believe there are a number of YMCAs around the country that are also partners with us in everything that is going on in the community of Haiti, but the Ann Arbor Y in Michigan, RY, YMCA Greater Boston, YMCA Greater New York, Ridgewood YMCA, YMCA Southern Arizona, the Tampa Metropolitan Y, Springfield College, Long Island, the Stanford YMCA in Connecticut, Greater Des Moines, Iowa, and the Philadelphia YMCA. So I think there's a dozen or so of YMCAs that are working together with us. So I now would like to just kind of show you some slides. Now, I will tell you that it was our hope and intent to have Fineal Apple on here with us tonight. And I was actually with him 2 weeks ago at a partners meeting in Montreal. Unfortunately, he's had a health situation in his family that prevented him from traveling here. My understanding is Vero just talked with him very recently further about the property, but he did ask me to extend his regrets. Now, in lieu of his ability being here, he did send us a little quick PowerPoint, and I'm not going to spend a lot of time, but if you would take a look at the screen, and I'm going to walk you through it. It is much longer than it should be, to be quite honest, but I think it will give you a sense of what we're talking about. So here we go. This is Guineal, who is the General Secretary of the YMCA in Haiti. There are, this is a land site that is under consideration, and again, our deep appreciation to Vero and his family. Now, to get a little bit about the, I will tell you, I was in Guineal, I'm sorry, I was in Haiti about a year ago, and I'll be going back in September. To be quite honest, the only way I can describe it, I was just devastated to see what I saw, and quite frankly, to see what good work the YMCA in that community is doing for people in some very tough circumstances, if you will. So presently, there are a number of YMCA program centers, and where's Marlene? Come here. And I'm not going to try to name the names, but I will be sure this is Marlene, would you mind?
All right. Actually, there's a 10 community YMCA in Haiti. We have some in Pittsburgh, in Labour, Port-au-Prince, Tampere, Laurent, La Colle, Marchand des Salines, Pointe-à-Marie, Cité Soleil, Bois des Bouquets. And one more that will be the next one will be in Jacmel. So therefore, with your contribution, with your help, we will make more.
I'm going home.
Thank you. So just this is much more, but this is kind of, you get the sense of what these container buildings actually look like. So I won't comment on each one, but it gives you an overview, if you will. This is a group of volunteers from the Haiti Y. By the way, as we think about our engagement, our hope was over the next 12 to 18 months, put a group of volunteers together to do, quite frankly, a trip to Haiti. Once all the details are in the works, to actually help in the construction of the Y in the Jacmel. So this is kind of how, it's just amazing, I will tell you, amazing what could be done with creative minds. Second, there are some slides that kind of begin to talk about what they do. I mentioned that I believe that at least when we began, my understanding was that the Y in Haiti was working with about 7,000 kids and families a year. In the last year alone, that number has now jumped to about 8,500 kids and families. And it just, I will tell you folks, everything that the Y does is essentially done as a result of fundraising in different communities. So, It's going to happen because of people like you and me and others that feel it's important enough for it to happen. So some of the areas that they're involved with is adult literacy. And you can see what some of the centers look like. There's also, by the way, a very strong partnership with Springfield College, who is one of the partner organizations that, and certainly students from Springfield every year have an opportunity to visit and actually work on behalf of the Y and the kids that it serves. Let me go back. This is, so the Y programs are centered in five core areas: after school, scholarship, camps, sports, STEM, literacy, and otherwise known as youth empowerment. A heavy after-school program in all the program centers. Certainly, the Y provides funding to continue for youth to continue their studies today. The Y supports 113 kids at three levels of elementary, high school, and university level. After school programs, a wide range of programs that include sports, psychological support, reading, arts, and recreation. Literacy is a very, very high need service in Haiti, and this is one of the primary things that youth work at the Y in Haiti is engaged in. Program also engages in empowering youth, and here's just a quick snapshot. And this program provides year-round training to youth from disadvantaged areas. The program teaches young people how to think and conceive in order to communicate well and demonstrate leadership skills. Each center has a young leaders club. Certainly, in Hawaii and the U.S., helping kids to become responsible and mature adults is a priority. This is the vehicle program by which that activity is offered in Haiti. Also, role model and mentoring is huge and in Y work, and certainly here annually there is a recognition of role models for young people. By the way, this gentleman here on the left, I don't recall his name, but his family is actually from Randolph, and he is the chair of the board of the Haiti YMCA, very, very passionate supporter of work. And women in the center is the honoree, and Vanille Lathalon, the general secretary, is on the right. Every year, the Y brings youth together between the ages of 10 to 17 so they can learn healthy lifestyles and values through youth sports, basketball, soccer, and volleyball. Approximately 160 kids are involved every summer. By the way, there's actually a group of Y leaders from, again, the Ridgewood Y that will be running the summer sports camp this summer.
Quite frankly, to
see what good work the YMCA in that community is doing for people in some very tough circumstances, if you will. So presently there are a number of YMCA program centers, and where's Marlene? Come here. And I'm not going to try to name the names, but I will be sure this is Marlene, would you mind?
Community YMCA in Haiti. We have some in Pittsburgh, in Labour, Port-au-Prince, Camperet, Laurent, La Colle, Marchand des Salines, Pont-à-Marie, Cité Soleil, Guadeloupe. And one more that will be the next one will be in Jacmel. So therefore, with your contribution, with your help, we will make more.
I'm going home.
Thank you. So just this is much more, but this is kind of, you get the sense of what these container buildings actually look like. So I won't comment on each one, but it gives you an overview, if you will. This is a group of volunteers from the Haiti Y. By the way, as we think about our engagement, our hope was over the next 12 to 18 months, put a group of volunteers together to do, quite frankly, a trip to Haiti, once all the details are in the works, to actually help in the construction of the Y in the Jacmel. So this is kind of how, it's just amazing, I will tell you, amazing what could be done with creative minds. Second, there are some slides that kind of begin to talk about what they do. I mentioned that I believe that at least when we began, my understanding was that the Y in Haiti was working with about 7,000 kids and families a year. In the last year alone, that number has now jumped to about 8,500 kids and families. And it just, I will tell you folks, everything that the Y does is essentially done as a result of fundraising in different communities. So, It's going to happen because of people like you and me and others that feel it's important enough for it to happen. So some of the areas that they're involved with is adult literacy. And you can see what some of the centers look like. There's also, by the way, a very strong partnership with Springfield College, who is one of the partner organizations, and certainly students from Springfield every year have an opportunity to visit and actually work on behalf of the Y and the kids that it serves. Let me go back. This is, so the Y programs are centered in five core areas: after school, scholarship, camps, sports, STEM, literacy, and leadership, otherwise known as youth empowerment. A heavy after school program in all the program centers. Certainly, the Y provides funding to continue, for youth to continue their studies today. The Y supports 113 kids at three levels of elementary, high school, and university level. After school programs, a wide range of programs that include sports, psychological support, reading, arts, and recreation. Literacy is a very, very high need service in Haiti, and this is one of the primary things that youth work at the Y in Haiti is engaged in. Program also engages in empowering youth, and here's just a quick snapshot. And this program provides year-round training to youth from disadvantaged areas. The program teaches young people how to think and conceive in order to communicate well and demonstrate leadership skills. Each center has a young leaders club. Certainly, in Hawaii and the U.S., helping kids to become responsible and mature adults is a priority. This is the vehicle program by which that activity is offered in Haiti. Also, role model and mentoring is huge, and in Y work, and certainly here, annually there is a recognition of role models for young people. By the way, this gentleman here on the left, I don't recall his name, but his family's actually from Randolph, and he is the chair of the board of the Haiti YMCA, very, very passionate supporter of work. And the woman in the center is the honoree, and Winnie Lathalon, the general secretary, is on the right. Every year, the Y brings youth together between the ages of 10 to 17 so they can learn healthy lifestyles and values from youth sports, basketball, soccer, and volleyball. Approximately 160 kids are involved every summer. By the way, there's actually a group of Y leaders from, again, the Ridgewood Y that will be running the summer sports camp this coming summer. The Latin American and Caribbean Alliance of YMCAs in early May. And there are, I guess, 68 YMCAs actually participating. So Y Haiti also is having an international dimension as well within its region. These are volunteers from different parts. This happens to be, I will tell you in a moment, I'm going to show you, but this particular couple recently went to Haiti, quite frankly, and is prepared to make a seven-figure gift for creating the first kind of YUSA-looking like YMCA center. I will show that to you in a minute. They also send numbers, but you know, by the way, it has an operating budget of about $400,000, and again, they're fiscally responsible, don't get above, you know, what they can do. But again, each and every dollar that they have essentially is provided by partner-wise in organizations. So we won't get into the details of this. This happens to be the meeting that I attended a year ago of the partner-wise. So like any organizations, part of the board's role is to concern itself on strategic planning and creating a very solvent, fiscally responsible future, and based on growth and continued program service. So I'm not going to. We actually approved their budget just a few weeks ago. But what I did want to show you is this is the flagship. Now, this is not what we're talking about doing here tonight. That's a separate effort, if you will. But, and I'm not sure that, quite frankly, each site has been selected for this yet. But, so if you look at what the facility is going to look like, it looks more like, if you will, full facility YMCAs here in the country. And so these are all artistic renderings, if you will, including what would be the first Y with a major outdoor aquatic complex. So that ends the PowerPoint presentation. I clearly spoke in longer than I should have, and I know there's more food and so forth, but seriously, really the challenge for us is to figure out how to raise the money in the next 12 months. And I know that there are brochures at your table. If any of you have any interest in being involved in any way, please let us know. I think there's something you can send in, or certainly, my name is Vinny, all the YMCA, etc., and you know, we'll be happy to help you or engage you in our efforts. And certainly for the rest of the evening, again, I thank you. There are still a fundraising things going on. I think there's still plenty of food, so please enjoy, and thank you so much. I'm going to introduce. Here's one of the very special people that I've come to know and appreciate over the last few years. And Marlene, you know, for those of you that know her, know exactly what I'm talking about. You know, it's rare when you have the opportunity to engage, you know, genuine people who are interested in doing good things for others. And she presently, in addition to being president president of the Haitian Community Partner. She also serves as a member of our of Downtown Brockton Y board. She's a real advocate for kids in our community, and it's great to have you, Marlene, helping us to get this job done. So,
thank you. Thank you. When we met with Philly, it was that the Haitian Women's Partners finding its partners. Because through the YMCA, we see ourselves as a small organization, how we can work together to empower our community. And YMCA gave us the opportunity to do that. So that's why today, if we're talking about why Haiti, it's not coming out of nowhere. It's coming because the grassroots work with the YMCA here. So I'm going to call some of the members of Haitian Community Partners, some of the board members. Pelagio Aslan, come on. Wester Dorsey. And Theo Pontet. Jean-Claude Sagan. Come on. Joseph. So you know how that those egos go. Between 12 men, there's 2 women, right? So we have to constantly fight to get our voice heard. But you know what? They said, we have strong will, and we are strong. And we cannot be strong by ourselves, even though we are 2 women in the group. But we have the 12 men around us to make us strong, to make us strong as a community. So that's the same mentality Haitian Community Partners bring to the community, as the same mentality that philosophy that the YMCA bring to the community. The community cannot be strong without each of us. And we will not have a community if we're not working together. So our organization models YMCA philosophy. Please. Help us make our community strong here and abroad. How are you going to do that? How can you do that? By investing in our community here, by giving back to the community. Because when you're giving back to the community here, you're helping someone in Haiti. It's not much. We only need $15,000 a year to have that dream keep going. $15,000, that's the operational money that we need. So we want you guys to help us. Before that $15,000, we need $34,000 to build that YMCA. Without your help, we cannot do it. So we want you to be very generous today. Very generous today. Please, $25, $50 on top of what you already did, that will help us make a dream come true. And please remember, when you have the YMCA over here, when you have a membership, when you donate, not only are you helping your community over here, but you're helping the Haitian kids in Haiti. Right now there's 9 YMCA in Haiti. Wouldn't that be great to see that in each city in Haiti we have a YMCA? Wouldn't that be great? So we're gonna do that, but we cannot do it by ourselves. We cannot do it by ourselves. We have as a community. Together we need to move forward, and moving forward we need to support each other. Thank you so much for your support and for your continued support. We really appreciate that. much.
I'm gonna get kicked out.